John Lennon of the Beatles, who knew Kenneth Anger, pretended to be a man of peace, but really wanted violent revolution. John Lennon said that the Beatles were as much revolutionaries as the Stones were. Notice John Lennon here after stating, but when you talk about destruction, don't you know that you can count me out, then changes out to in, showing the Beatles' true intent for violent revolution. But when you talk about destruction, don't you know that you can count me out, The Rolling Stones and the Beatles promoted Crowley's satanic revolution with their albums, Their Satanic Majesty's Request and Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. With Their Satanic Majesty's Request, the Stones employed the same name for Satan as did Anger's film, Lucifer Rising. On the front cover of the album, Mick Jagger is seen dressed like a warlock. And at the top of the album, Their Satanic Majesty's Request, we see the alignment of planets supposedly heralding the Crowleyan Satanic Age. Brian Jones of the Rolling Stones said at this time, quote, I believe we're moving toward a new age in ideas and events. Astrologically, we are at the end of the age called the Pisces Age, of the beginning of which people like Christ were born. We're soon to begin the age of Aquarius, in which events is important, as those at the beginning of Pisces are likely to occur. There is a young revolution in thought and manner about to take place. What few people realize is that Their Satanic Majesty's Request was put out in conjunction with the Beatles' Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band album to promote the new age of Satan. Both came out in 1967, both were highly psychedelic, and both were poised to take the hippie revolution further down the path of Crowley's satanic revolution. Both albums are also heavily adorned with Eastern mystical symbols and drugs. Both the Beatles and the Rolling Stones are wearing uniforms, and both are pictured with deadpan looks upon their faces. Notice on the front cover of the Beatles' Sgt. Pepper's is the statement, Welcome the Rolling Stones. Tony Sanchez wrote in his book Up and Down with the Rolling Stones about a Beatles and Rolling Stones meeting where they talked, quote, long into the night about music and revolution and how they were going to change the world. On the front cover of the Rolling Stones album, Their Satanic Majesty's Request, a slightly veiled picture of John Lennon is seen. This same picture is also found on the inside sleeve of Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band album. On the Stones album, we also see a semi-camouflage picture of George Harrison of the Beatles, his head being covered with magic mushrooms, a biblically forbidden doorway to Satan called Pharmakia. Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band album is covered with a collage of people known as the Magic Crowds. These are the faces of different people that the Beatles considered part of the mystical club. The Beatles described them as their heroes and people they looked up to. In this crowd, you find pictures of one-worlders like Karl Marx and mystics like Edgar Allan Poe and Carl Jung and Aldous Huxley, who Crowley reportedly turned on to mescaline. The Beatles also placed a picture of occultist William Burroughs, who claimed to have become demon-possessed after killing his wife on the Sgt. Pepper's album. Also making the cast was the most popular starlet of the 1960s, Jane Mansfield. Mansfield was a high priestess in Anton LaVey's Church of Satan. Mansfield admitted to using her Satanism to both seduce and gain worldwide fame. The Beatles also placed a slew of Eastern gurus on the album as they continued their assault on Christianity. Incredibly, one of the people who was to be pictured on the album as part of the Beatles Club was none other than Adolf Hitler. Hitler was yanked presumably because he was considered too controversial to appear on the album. Hitler's picture can be seen on the sidelines just prior to the shooting of the album cover. It has been well documented that Nazism was rooted in the occultic teachings of Madame Blavatsky and others. Aleister Crowley claimed that Hitler was his disciple and was seeking to implement the teachings of the Book of the Law through his policies of the triumph of the will. And of course, as we have noted on the top left, we find the picture of none other than Aleister Crowley. It is believed that Crowley is the one that the Beatles are referring to when in the song Sgt. Pepper's they state it was 20 years ago today that Sgt. Pepper taught the band to play. It was 20 years before the release of this album, almost to the day when Crowley died, and many of his followers believe marked the beginning of the new age. Crowley declared that he would lead an army of youth in the revolution to implement the new age, and apparently the Beatles dubbed him Sgt. Pepper.
John Lennon stated, there were very few things that happened to the Beatles that weren't really well thought out. Lennon said that he realized that he was part of a club of mystics who had been initiated into the same spiritual club. God's word in the book of Revelation describes Satan's church as the Whore of Babylon. She is depicted as a sorceress, and Revelation chapter 17 verse 4 states, quote, the woman was dressed in purple and scarlet and was glittering with gold, precious stones, and pearls. She held a golden cup in her hand, filled with the abominable things and the filth of her adulteries. A depiction of the Satanic Church or the Scarlet Woman, as both Crowley and Anger refer to her, is found on the Sgt. Pepper's album. Crowley taught that the Beast and the Scarlet Woman would gather their children into their fold and bring the glories of the stars into the hearts of men. Notice on the Sgt. Pepper's album, we see a sorceress adorned in scarlet and with precious stones and gold and pearls. Notice also that she is holding up a golden cup in her hand, as the book of Revelation states. Notice in her other hand, she's holding an upside-down pentagram. The London Times said that Sgt. Pepper's was, quote, a decisive moment in the history of Western civilization. It was a decisive moment at this time in history as Satan made major inroads in preparing the world for the coming of the Antichrist. Ringo Starr, in a takeoff from Sgt. Pepper's, put out an album where he is seen with a demon or a fallen angel. Ringo Starr seems to be conveying the idea that he is being influenced by this spirit. In fact, at the top of this album, we see that Ringo Starr depicts himself as merely a puppet on the wizard's hand. God's word says that we wrestle not against flesh and blood, like Ringo Starr, but against principalities and powers and the rulers of the darkness of this world and spiritual wickedness in high places. Demonic beings who are using human beings to advance Satan's agenda.
I mean, you know, that Summer of Love, a lot of that was bull****, really. It was all what the press was saying.
After the 1960s had passed, George Harrison of the Beatles would admit that the so-called love of the hippie movement was a delusion that was really destructive.
You know, I went to Haight Ashbury expecting it to be this brilliant place, and it was just full of horrible, spotty, dropout kids on drugs. It certainly showed me what was really happening in the drug cult. It wasn't what I thought of all these groovy people getting, having spiritual awakenings and being autistic. It was just, it was like the Bowery. It was like alcoholism. It was like any addiction.